Hello students, welcome you back to the computer class. I hope you are enjoying the computer classes and you have done the homework as well. So in the previous class, whatever we have done till now, so let us have a quick revision before moving further. So in the last class, we discussed about few of the fundamentals of the computer. So we have studied about what exactly is a computer, how it is useful in various areas. Clear? After that, we were reading about the how the different terms which are related to computer are defined, like what is data, what is instruction. So data was the unorganized fact and instruction is the operation which we tell the computer to perform. For example, if you are giving two numbers, so here as you can see, this the two numbers, this was a raw data, and when it was added and it was to find out the total of these two printers and monitor, that is the total output devices, so this was a instruction. Clear? And also we have revised some other concept, like the different terms which we have earlier discussed, like what is processing, information, user, hardware and software we have discussed. So the difference, basic difference between hardware and software, that hardware is the mechanical equipment attached to the computer and software is the instructions which are given to the computer to perform some tasks. So this we have already discussed. I hope you have revised and done the homework as well. Clear? After that, we have discussed some benefits, that what are the different benefits of the computer. We have discussed the terms associated with the different benefits, that is speed, quality, reliability, storage capacity and versatility. After that, we have seen the different things which we can do with the help of computer. Then we have seen this IPO cycle, that was the input, processing and output. So in this diagram, it is very much clear that with the help of different input, processing and output devices, how the computer work. So this was very well explained. After that, we have seen, or we were discussing about the different terms, that is input, process, output and storage. So in the last class, we have done till these explanation of these all four terms. So from today, we are going to know about the various input devices, what are the different input devices and how they are used and in which areas they are used. So let us see. So first one, any hardware, let us see what is input device first. So any hardware component that allows you to enter data, instruction and command into a computer is called as input device. So clear? So any device using which we give the command to the computer, as you use the mouse to click somewhere on the screen, you use keyboard to write something, whatever the key we press, all those letters are being written on the computer screen in MS Word or any notepad or WordPad file. So these devices act as a input device. So let us see one by one these devices. Everyone has, most of these devices you have seen also. So first one is the keyboard. All you have seen and familiar. A keyboard is an input device that contains keys. You press it keys to type information and enter instructions for the computer to follow. Then normally the desktop computer's keyboard have 101 to 105 keys. It varies as per the different different keyboard as per the requirement. So generally the desktop computers have 101 to 105 keys. Clear? And it may vary, that you can see also in the laptop computers the number of keys are little bit less. Clear? And in some of the gaming laptops there are some extra buttons, or in multimedia keyboard there are some other buttons to control the different sound, then the brightness of the screen. Clear? So these will add more number of keys on the keyboard. Next is mouse. So you have seen also and you have used this also, that how the mouse is act as a input device. So a mouse is a pointing device that fits comfortably under the palm of your hand. You can use the mouse to select or move items on the screen, as well as provide instructions for the computer to follow. The top of mouse has two buttons. So here you can see also the normally the trackball, there is a roller below the surface of the computer, and there are two buttons left and right, and in between there is a scroll, which the scroll wheel, which you can scroll so that the page can be scrolled up and down. Clear? And using the left and right, we can click the left and right button. So these mouse are now coming in various forms. So earlier they were the roller mouse having a ball beneath it. Now the mouse have some light emitting. So these are the new form of the mouse, which the coordinates of the mouse actually moves as we move the light of that laser light or whatever the light technology is used. So as it the beam of the light moves, the cursor also moves. So it may be a wired mouse as well as the wireless mouse, as we see in the form of Bluetooth mouses. Clear? So these are the various forms of the mouse which we see. Next is scanner. So scanner, you can see in, as you have seen the photocopy machine in most of the places, in the same way the scanner is something many of you have seen as well. When you go to some shopkeeper at a computer shop, when you get something scanned, or when you go to a photo studio, you give a photograph to get it prepared more number of copies from the photograph, from the photo. In that case, the shopkeeper keeps the photo on these scanners so that it can be scanned. So how it is used, let us see. A scanner is an input device used to send images and text directly into computer. You can scan images such as photographs, drawings and logos into a computer. Commonly used scanners are flatbed scanner and handheld scanner. So what is the difference in between these two types? Let us see. So the flatbed scanner is something where it has a flat surface, and on that surface you keep the item to be scanned. So this is example of flatbed scanner. And in handheld scanner, it is a type of a device which has a very small area, so you move the scanner over the page of the document to be scanned. So this is the difference in between the mechanism. In the flatbed, you keep the item on the surface of the scanner, and in the handheld scanner, you move the scanner over the surface of the book or whatever the item you want to scan. Let us read this also. So in the flatbed scanner, this scanner works similarly to a photocopy machine, except that it creates a file of the document in a computer memory instead of a paper copy. So is it clear? As we see the photocopy machine, so in the photocopy machine, whatever the item we want to copy, it comes in the form of a page, which is the copy of the item which we have given. But in the scanner, whatever the item which we are scanning, the copy of that item is created inside the computer, that it creates a digital copy of the document. Clear? So this is the example of flatbed scanner. Now in handheld scanner, it is a portable device that can be held in one hand. Clear? And this scanner is dragged over the object to be scanned, and it is mostly used in the shopping stores. So when you purchase some items, so there are some marks which is written, the price which is written, so all that can also be scanned using the handheld scanner. Now next is the barcode scanner. Let us see what is barcode scanner. So most products in the shops have barcodes on them. A barcode is a set of lines of different thickness that gives information about the product like its price, manufacturing date, etc. The barcode reader, also called a barcode scanner, is used to input data from barcodes. So see here, and you can see the different items when you purchase. Not only the items, if you see your book or the notebook, at the back side of that you can find a similar lines, a very thick and thin lines, a combination of various lines. The thickness of that varies, clear? So actually these lines contains the coded detail of the manufacturer, the price of the item, the date when it is manufactured. So all these details, when it is scanned by a barcode reader, all the information digitally is transferred to the computer. So when the bill or the invoice is printed, all the details are fetched from this barcode and quickly it generates a slip of that. Clear? So this way the barcode reader acts as an input device, and this way they can be used for various commercial purpose in the shops or in multiplexes or in shopping complex. So I hope this is clear. Now moving further to the next, let us see which input device is the next. The next is the joystick. So many of you also have seen this while playing games. So let us read this. A joystick is a pointing device which is used to control the actions in a computer game. So it has a vertical lever mounted on a base. You move the lever in different directions to control the actions in a game. Clear? So in the joystick we have a lever. So when you move the lever in the joystick, the game in which you are playing, the game control can be done with the help of this lever. So this way the joystick is a pointing device which is used in playing games. Okay, next is the graphic tablet. So graphic tablet is also example of a input device. So graphic tablet, also called digitizer, is an input device which has a special pen or a stylus to write on it. Clear? So these graphic tablets is also input device, and they have a special pen. Here you can see also that this special pen is used to write on the digital tablet. Clear? So this stylus, this pen is called as stylus or digitizer. Clear? So this enables the person to write on a surface. So as you write on the copy using pen and paper, in the same way this stylus can be used to write on this graphical tablet, and also it can be used to draw images on the computer as well as to give instructions to the computer. Clear? So this graphic tablet is also a form of input device. All these devices from which you can give the input to the computer, they all act as a input device. I hope this is clear. Now coming to the next input device, that is digital camera. Let us, everyone has seen also, nowadays the mobile phones also have very good quality of camera. So this all camera and the digital camera is example of a input device. So a digital camera, also called as digicam, is an electronic input device used to capture and store photographs electronically in a computer instead of using photographic films used in the conventional cameras. So earlier the cameras were having some magnetic tape or a magnetic reel on which the images were clicked, and then it were used to create the photograph. Clear? So they were the photographic film cameras, but nowadays the camera which we use, they are the digital camera. They are also called as digicam, in which whatever the snapshot or the image which we click with the camera, they are stored in a digital form, and with the help of computer they can be processed and get it can be printed in the form of a photograph on a paper. That is a special quality of photo paper. Clear? So this way the digital camera also act as a input device. I hope this is clear. Now next input device is MICR reader, that is magnetic ink character reader. So whatever the acronyms or the short forms which you are facing while reading the chapter, please note it down in the notebook. Clear? Like MICR right now, then before this we have studied about IPO, that is information processing cycle. Clear? Then CPU. Clear? So all these types of short forms, they are required to be written in the notebook as well, so that it will be easy for you in the exams. So MICR reader is an input device used to read and identify magnetized characters printed on a document such as check. So nowadays the bank checks which we see, they have a, at the bottom you can see they have a magnetic ink character written at the bottom, as you can see here. Clear? So they are the special type of letters which are written with the help of a magnetic ink. Clear? So by only scanning this character, that is magnetic character, it can be known that from which, who is the account, means this check belongs to whose, which person or which company, then what is the bank associated with that. So clear? So all these types of details are magnetically present in the form of these magnetic characters at the bottom of the check. Clear? You can also use these types of checks at home of your parents. If they have, then you can see at the bottom they have the special type of characters, clear, which are encoded, and these types of checks can be scanned using this MICR reader, that is the magnetic ink character reader. Clear? So these MICR readers are the input devices using which the MICR checks can be scanned or can be processed. Clear? So these also are example of input devices. Now next is the touch screen. So the touch screen is also example of a input device. When you go to the ATM or the mobile which you are using, so any of these devices where you can give the input using your fingers, that is the touch screen. So this also acts as a input device. Let us read. A touch screen is a screen that you can touch with your finger to input information. Your fingers act as a pointing device. The tablet, PC, smartphones and the ATMs use touch screen to input instructions. Clear? So this way the touch screen also act as a input device. I hope this much is clear, and as it is also easy and interesting to know, so these all are examples of input devices. Now let us see the next input device is microphone. I will discuss this, update your knowledge box also. Before this, let us one remaining input device, that is microphone. So microphone is a voice input device used to send our voice into the computer. Clear? So this microphone also records our voice and it takes the voice as the input. So this microphone also acts as a input device. Clear? So you can use the microphone for instant messaging that support voice conversations, chat rooms that support voice chats and voice recognition. Clear? So this microphone also is an example of input device. Now let us come back to the box, which is update your knowledge. So let us see what is this. So you usually interact with a touch screen using gestures. A gesture is a motion you make on touch screen with the tip of one or more fingers on your hand. So this is how we use our fingers to use the touch screen. So when you single tap, that is the tap is used for quickly touching. This is the description of this tap. When you touch and release one finger at a time, so what is the use of this? This activates a link or press a button. So whenever you are tapping something, so this is associated with activating a link or pressing a button. If you double tap, if you click the things two times, so what will it do? It will run a program or app or zoom in. So suppose if that there is an image, and if you double click on that, it will be zoomed in, means the size of the image will be enlarged. In the same way, if there is an app, if you double tap it, it will be started. Clear? Press and hold. So if you press and hold one finger to cause an action to occur or until an action occur. So this is a shortcut to, this is used to display a shortcut menu. Clear? If you touch and keep the fingers touched there only, then if there is any shortcut of that or a shortcut menu of that, it will be displayed to you. Next is drag or line. If you drag in one direction, so it will move the item around the screen. You can move anything from a place to another. Then swipe. Swipe means by pressing and holding one finger and moving the finger horizontally or vertically on the screen. So clear. So this operation is called as swiping. So this is used for scrolling. If you want to scroll something up and down, you can use your finger to swipe up and down. So as you move the finger, the page will be scrolled up or down. Then stretching. If you move the two fingers apart, if you touch the screen with your both fingers at the same place, after that when you move the fingers apart while touching the screen, it will zoom in, means the size will be enlarged. And if we pinch, means from away, if you will bring the fingers closer, as you see in the diagram also, so this will zoom out, means the size will be reduced. Clear? So this way we have revised the different gestures of or the motion of our fingers for using the touch screen surfaces. Clear? I hope already you are using this, so already you are familiar about this. Now coming to the different output devices. So till now we have seen the different input devices. Now we will see the different output devices. So let us see. An output device is an hardware component. An output device is an hardware component that can convey information to a user. Some commonly used output devices are display devices like monitor, printer and speaker. So let us see one by one about this. So first one is a monitor. So monitor is an example of output device. Everywhere you can see the monitor and it looks like a television screen. It displays the work done by you or the information you get after processing. Information on monitor exists electronically and is displayed for a temporary period of time. For this reason, information on the monitor is also referred to as the soft copy. Clear? So what is soft copy? Soft copy is the digital form of the data which is displayed on the screen of the monitor. And what is hard copy? Anything which we see which is printed on the paper, that is called as hard copy. Clear? So monitor is used for displaying the soft copy or the digital form of any data. Monitor is also known as screen, display, video screen or VDU, that is video display unit. Clear? So these are all the synonym of monitor. Clear? I hope this is clear that monitor is used for displaying the soft copy or a digital form of the data. Next output device is printer. So printer is an output device that gives you the output on a physical medium such as paper. Clear? So earlier you have seen that monitor is used to display the electronic display or the digital display, that is soft copy. But in the case of printer, you get the output on a physical medium such as a paper, that is called as printout. Clear? So printout is the physical printed form of any data. So the information we get as a printout on a paper is called as hard copy. Clear? So the difference between hard copy and soft copy is clear. Next, let us see what are the different types of the printers. Clear? So the printers are basically classified in three types. Let us see one by one. The first is the laser printer. So this printer used laser technology to print text or images on a paper. It gives the best quality output and is the most expensive. The speed of this printer is given in PPM, that is pages per minute. So all the modern printers which we see at the computer shops, in the cyber cafes, or also when you want to get your photo printed, so they all use the laser printers. Clear? So they are, the quality of these printers are very good, and the speed of them is also better than the other printers, and the speed is given in PPM, that is per page per minute, how many pages can be printed. Now the next form of the printer is inkjet printer. Let us see what is inkjet printer. So these printers output text and images by spraying ink on the paper. So inkjet printer produce the text and graphics in both black and white and color. So the speed of this printer is given in line per minute, that is LPM. Clear? So the difference between laser and inkjet is that in the laser printer we use the laser light or the laser technology, but in inkjet printer we have a jet of the ink which is sprayed on the paper. Clear? The technology is used of the jet of ink, so that's why it is called as inkjet printer, by spraying the ink on the paper. By the name itself it is clear. So this is of both quality, that is black and white and color, and they are little bit slower than the laser printer, and the speed is measured in lines per minute. Clear? So this is the features of inkjet printer. Now next is the dot matrix printer. So let us see what is dot matrix printer. So these printer contains movable print head with pins that strike the ribbon, placing a dot on the paper. So these printers are less expensive but are very noisy. The speed of this printer is given in character per second. So the dot matrix printer were the earlier form of the printer, and it you can see these type of printer when you go to some railway station to get your ticket printed. So all those types of printer, or in the post office if you post some letter or any parcel, so then you receive some receipt which is printed. So these types of printers, these types of dot matrix printers are used to print those things, your tickets, then the booking counter at the post office booking counter. So these types of dot matrix technology is used, and the speed of them is lesser, and it is measured in character per second. Clear? I hope this is clear by the example also. Now next is the speaker. So a speaker is also a form of output device. So the speakers are the output devices that produce music, speech, or other sounds that your computer generate or processes. Clear? So the speakers are output device, and as you all while watching the movies, playing the games, you use the speakers. So the difference between a speaker and microphone is the microphone is used to record the voice, so it act as a input device. But in the case of a speaker, they are used to listen the voice or a song or a video. Clear? So in this case the speaker act as a output device. Clear? I hope this is clear. Then the next is the storage devices. So till now we have seen the input device and output device. So let us start the storage device also. So first let us see what is a storage device. The storage devices enables you to store data and information. They can hold data, instructions and information for future use. Clear? So the storage devices are used for storing the data, so that whenever in the future you need the same data, so you can use the storage device to retrieve the data from these devices. Clear? Now one by one let us see what are the different storage devices. So the first storage device is hard disk drive. So hard disk drive, which we see in the computer, that is the HDD or the hard disk, is your computer's main permanent storage area. द हार्ड डिस्क सिट्स इनसाइड द कंप्यूटर केस एंड स्टोर्स योर प्रोग्राम्स एंड डॉक्यूमेंट्स. इट इज़ द डिस्क पैक दैट कंसिस्ट ऑफ मैनी इनफ्लेक्सिबल सर्कुलर प्लेटर्स दैट यूज मैग्नेटिक पार्टिकल्स टू स्टोर डेटा इंस्ट्रक्शंस एंड इंफॉर्मेशन. सो मोस्ट करेंट हार्ड डिस्क ड्राइव्स हैव स्टोरेज कैपेसिटी ऑफ 500 GB टू 8 TB एंड इवन मोर. क्लियर. सो द हार्ड डिस्क इन द कंप्यूटर दे लुक लाइक समथिंग विच इज गिवन इन द दिस डायग्राम. क्लियर. सो दीज हार्ड डिस्क आर यूज एंड दे आर एक्चुअली प्लेटर्स ऑफ सम देर इज अ सिलेंडर ऑफ सम प्लेटर्स. सो दिस वे देर आर फ्यू सिलेंडर्स एंड दे आर माउंटेड ऑन अ दिस टाइप ऑफ स्ट्रक्चर. क्लियर. सो दिस वे इन बिटवीन दीज प्लेटर्स देर इज सम रीड राइट हेड. क्लियर. एंड दीज प्लेटर्स द राउंड प्लेटर्स दीज आर एक्चुअली देर इज अ स्टैक ऑफ दीज प्लेटर्स. क्लियर. वन अपॉन वन देन दिस वे दिस इज द स्टैक लेयर बाई लेयर. सो दिस वे दिस इज इन साइड दिस केस. क्लियर. सो दिस वे द हार्ड डिस्क स्टोर्स आवर डेटा इनसाइड द कंप्यूटर और योर कैबिनेट. क्लियर. सो दिस वे दिस डेटा इज स्टोर्ड इन फॉर्म ऑफ द मैग्नेटिक फॉर्म एंड द साइज ऑफ दिस हार्ड डिस्क इज वेरी मच. यू कैन स्टोर वेरी मैनी मूवीज एंड अ लार्ज अमाउंट ऑफ डेटा इन योर कंप्यूटर. सो नाउ डेज देर आर दे कम्स इन टेराबाइट. अर्लियर द साइजेस वेर कमिंग इन द गीगाबाइट्स बट नाउ दीज डेज देर दे कम इन टेराबाइट दैट इज टेराबाइट TB and GB is gigabyte. Next storage device is the optical disc, that is the different CD, DVD and Blu-ray disc. So I hope you have seen these discs when you watch some movie. These types of CDs can be purchased from the different storage or the gallery houses. Other than this, the different software are also come in these preloaded in these CDs. So all of these different optical disc we will discuss in the next class. Before that, whatever you have studied till today, revise these topics once again, the different input devices. So for today, the homework is you have to write the five input devices with their definition, and in that you can give the barcode reader, joystick and MICR. So define these three are must, that is MICR, barcode and the joystick. So these three, other than this, include two more. So in the notebook also you can write about the five input devices with their definition. Clear. And if you are facing any doubt, any difficulty, so be ready with your questions in the next online and live session which we will have. And in between also you can send me the message on the WhatsApp group as well as on my email ID. Clear. Till then, stay safe and healthy and be indoor. Okay. Thank you, class.